Hi, this is Kevin Watson from the Centre for Academic Development at Oxford Brookes University. Here's another video aimed at trying to take the stress out of the dissertation experience. Today, looking at how to create an automatic table of contents in Word. Here I am in a Word document, and I've got a blank page at the beginning where I'm going to put a contents page. This is going to sound obvious, but in order to create a contents page, Word needs to know which parts of your text are actually normal text and which parts are headings, and just bolding it won't do that. So what you've got to do is use something that's on the Home tab, and it's headings basically. If you look in the middle of the Home tab at the top on the ribbon there, you'll see it says normal, no spacing, heading 1, heading 2, heading 3, heading 4, and it will go on even further than that. But I'm just going to use, for way of demonstration, heading 2 and 3 and the normal. I'm assuming that heading 1, for example, would be perhaps the title of my dissertation. All right, so here we are then. We're going to actually just add, first of all, an extra heading. If I click down here, you'll see just a normal paragraph here. Here it just says normal at the top, and this identifies that this is not a heading, it's just normal text. I'm going to add an extra heading just above that, and I'm going to call this introduction. I'm going to select heading 3, and I've got a differentiation going on here. Heading 2 I'm using for chapter headings, heading 3 I'm using for kind of subsections within a chapter. So here I'll put introduction. And I could change the font size of that or the font style as I want to. But the principle is, if I click on it now where it says introduction, you'll see that up here at the top, it's highlighted as a heading 3. So that's what I would do. I would go through and make sure that all my headings are in heading 3. And at the top of my chapter, you'll see that the chapter is heading 2. So I've got a logic there. Now I'm going to go to my blank page where I want my contents page. And to generate a contents page, you go to the References tab. And you'll see on the References tab, right on the left-hand side there, a table of contents option. So I'm going to click on that, and I'm going to select whichever one of these I think might be most appropriate. And we can see here now then an automatic table of contents. This is useful in so many ways. If you do it manually, it means every time your page numbers change, you've got to go back and change your contents page. But with this, you can update it. You can see there's an update option there on the top left. And the other great thing, if your document gets quite big, you can actually click on various bits and it will take you straight to that section. So that is how you create a contents page using Word.